Today is Palm Sunday and the week leading up to the Passion of Christ. Welcome to all our viewers on social media and our listeners on 101.5 FM Radio St. Martin. This worship service is brought to you from the Methodist Circuit on St. Martin. We are thankful that we are able to bring you the good news of Jesus Christ during this global crisis in order to assure you that we are victors and not victims to COVID-19. We trust that this worship experience will be a blessing to you and that we will continue to claim victory in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. When the time was come for the Lord Jesus to be received up, he steadfastly set his face to go to Jerusalem. Today we remember his triumphal entry as king into the holy city, as the prophets had foretold. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. We now go to the hymn, All Glory, Lord and Honor.
Glory, Lord and Honor.
now go to God in prayer. Let us pray. Jehovah, our God, you are our salvation. Be gracious to us in this our time of need, we beseech you. We thank you that you are still Jehovah Nissi. The Lord is our banner. You are indeed a mighty warrior who have conquered Satan and sin. We pray that your Holy Spirit will guide, guard, care, and protect us so that we might be able to overcome this global epidemic. We cannot fight this battle on our own, Lord, and as such, we depend upon you to go before us even now. This we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Yes, my brothers and sisters, we now go to the ministry of the Word. The collect for today, as printed in our lectionary, Lord Jesus Christ, you humbled yourself in taking the form of a servant and in obedience died on the cross for our salvation. Give us the mind to follow you and to proclaim you as Lord and King to the glory of God the Father. The scripture reading comes to us from Zechariah chapter 9, reading from verse 9 to verse 10. Here I begin. Rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you. Triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem, and the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall command peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth. Here ends the reading of God's holy word. Thanks be to God. The psalm for today is Psalm 118, verses 1 to 2. And 19 to 29. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you for the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light. Bind the festal procession with branches up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, I will extol you. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. At this time, my brothers and sisters, we go to the ministry of the word, the message. Let us go to God in prayer as we prepare our hearts for the message. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, speak through me, and may your word go forth with power and conviction. Amen. Today's message, my brothers and sisters, is a message of victory. Victory. Victory in Jesus. Today, Palm Sunday, we celebrate the triumphal entry of Jesus into Jerusalem, where he fixed his eyes, knowing that he had the victory over sin and death. The words according to Zechariah 9 verse 9 was fulfilled. Rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you, triumphant and victorious is he. The triumphal entry of Jesus is most relevant in our present situation, as it teaches us three main things: that we must remain steadfast and humble even in adversity, that Jesus has given us authority over disease and death, and that we need to celebrate our victory through Jesus, our Savior. Number one, remain steadfast and humble. The triumphal entry teaches us that we must remain steadfast and humble even in adversity. Although Jesus knew that within a week after being praised as prophet and king, that he would have been killed in Jerusalem, he still set his eyes like flint on that holy city into which he rode. Death was staring him in the face, but he rode on with pomp and pride. He made his glory known, and many of the people were excited about his arrival as they hailed Hosanna, which means save now. These very people, however, later shouted, crucify him! Crucify him! Like Jesus, going from being praised to be crucified, and doctors across the world are being commended for the great work they are doing, I understand that in some parts of India, they have been running for their lives if they lose a patient. Therefore, it is important that we, like Christ, be steadfast and humble, even in times of adversities. We should not feel defeated by our situation, for Jesus is our defender. Martin Luther King Jr. and countless others knew this truth, and that is the reason He was able to join hands with thousands and sing, "We shall overcome." Sing with me. We shall overcome. We shall overcome someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do. Shall overcome someday. We also have an assurance that we are on to victory. We are on to victory. We are on to victory someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we are on to victory someday. So we praise the Lord that many people have now turned to him and are now at present praying, "Save us, Lord." Nonetheless, my question is, will they remain steadfast and humble after we have triumphed over this pandemic? I challenge us, therefore, that even though COVID-19 is all around us, that we should remember that God is in the midst of it all, and that he will deliver us like he did Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The songwriter declares, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved like a tree planted by the waters. I shall not be moved. So as Jesus rode on a donkey, which represents humility, may we remain steadfast and humble in this difficult time. Number two, authority over disease and death. The triumphal entry of Jesus teaches us that we have been given authority over disease and death. The disciples, after the Great Commission in Matthew 28:19-20, cured the sick and even restored the dead to life. Additionally, in Matthew 21:1-11, Jesus sent his disciples to go and loose someone's donkey and to take it to him. He instructed them as to what to say when they were questioned. "The Lord is in need of it," they replied. According to the passage, when the owner heard that it was Jesus who sent the disciples, he allowed them to take his donkey. This shows how powerful the name of Jesus is. Today, Christ wants us to recognize his power and authority in any situation, whether it is simply through a man's donkey, as in the passage, or in the case of our current pandemic. Hence, we thank God that we have been given such authority to claim victory over disease and death. The world needs to understand that Christ, who is the King and the Savior of the world, has anointed believers in his power and authority, and because of that, even disease and death have to submit to us if it is God's will. Therefore, may we acknowledge Jesus's authority as King of the world, for when he commands, even COVID-19 has to surrender. Number three and final, celebrate the victory. Celebrate your victory through Jesus. The triumphal entry teaches us that we must celebrate our victory through Jesus. Today, as we celebrate Palm Sunday, we acknowledge that palm branches symbolize victory. The people waved palm branches and spread their cloaks on the ground as Jesus rode into Jerusalem. It was in the very area that Jesus was that his victory would be seen. Because after his death, within 3 days, he rose triumphantly to save the world from sin. So, as Jesus rode into Jerusalem, he celebrated his own victory. In our present context, we can turn then what seems like defeat to us into victory. For through our faith in Christ, we can have the assurance that in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. As we celebrate, may we keep holding high our banner of victory through Jesus, singing and rejoicing with the songwriter, God moves in a mysterious way. God moves in a mysterious way. God moves in a mysterious way. His wonders to perform. He plants his feet. He plants his footsteps on the sea and rides upon the storm. Indeed, God moves in a mysterious way, my brothers and sisters, and he will give us victory. So in closing, I say to us, I therefore encourage us to be steadfast and humble, even in times of adversity. If you have not yet given your life to Jesus Christ, his word says, today, if you hear my voice, do not harden your heart. So accept Jesus today before it is too late. He will give you authority over disease and death, and you will be able to celebrate in victory that we will triumph over this trial that we now face. So may God bless you. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. We go on now to the prayer of intercession. And I invite you, fellow believers in Christ, to chant with me right now. We are in perilous times. We are in serious times, and I invite you to join with me in spirit to plead the blood of Jesus against this disease. Let us trample down Satan's kingdom in the name of Jesus. The Lord be with you. Let us chant. We praise you, great Jehovah, for your church triumphant and your church militant. Your church, O God, is built upon Jesus the rock, and the gates of hell cannot prevail against it. We, your church, come against the coronavirus disease that came out in 2019. We call that demon by its name right now, Jesus. COVID-19. COVID-19. We send you back to the pit of hell in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We plead the blood of Jesus against you, COVID-19. We rebuke you in the name of Jesus Christ, COVID-19. Get behind us in the name of Jesus right now, COVID-19. We cancel you in the name of Jesus right now, COVID-19. We send the fire of the Holy Spirit to burn you up right now, COVID-19. We declare victory over you right now in the name of Jesus, COVID-19. We speak it in authority into the atmosphere in the name of Jesus Christ, and we vanquish you, COVID-19. And so, O Lord, remember all those who are hospitalized and those who have been confirmed with the virus. May your healing hand be upon them now. This we pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. 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 We continue to chant in prayer with the prayer of victory in Psalm 21 to 2 and 4 to 9. The Lord answer you in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob protect you. May he send you help from his sanctuary and give you support from Zion. May he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill all your plans. May we shout for joy over your victory, and in the name of our God set up our banners. May the Lord fulfill all your petitions. Now I know that the Lord will help his anointed. He will answer him from his holy heaven with mighty victories by his right hand. Some take pride in chariots and some in horses, but our pride is in the name of the Lord our God. They will collapse and fall, but we shall rise and stand upright. Give victory to the King, O Lord. Answer us when we call. Yes, my brothers and sisters, we give God the glory. And I praise God that we were able to join and declare victory over the plan of the enemy. The hymn right now as we go to the final closing of this viewing, we sing the hymn together, Victory in Jesus, My Savior Forever.
Precious blood atoning, may thy
receive the benediction. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Amen. Thanks for worshiping with us today and for the positive messages that you have sent for last week's service. Please continue to fellowship with us weekly so that we may all be strengthened in our faith in Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. So please stay safe.